Hey everybody, how are you? I'm so excited to be here for the 50 Shades of Truth after party. So we just had an incredible episode with the Amanda Bond, who is an amazing Facebook ad strategist. So if you haven't seen the interview, then head over to my Facebook page and you can find it somewhere in the feed. If you're watching this inside of the Success Alchemist Society, then it should be the video below this. So afterwards, go ahead, take a look at it. But today in the after party, and for those of you who don't know what the after party is all about, basically what we do is we take a controversial or a hot topic spoken about inside of the episode, and I will riff on it a little bit here and tell you my opinion, my take on it, and also invite you to share what's coming up for you around it and just have a discussion. So I would love for you to let me know that you're here, give me some hearts, give me a hello, but I would love to know, have any of you ever felt like, oh my gosh, you know, my business, it's going well, I'm seeing some success, but it just doesn't feel right. Something is not in alignment for me. Something just feels off. If you've ever felt that way, give me some hearts so I can know if you are resonating with this and if you've ever felt that way yourself. Because this is something that I felt many times inside of my business. And hello, welcome to all of you who are joining us. I'm wondering if you've ever felt like you had a successful business, but you're ready to burn it to the ground because it just doesn't feel in alignment for you. But before we even think about burning it to the ground, I think that what can be so dangerous, and I mentioned this inside of the interview with Bond, is that especially when we see something is working, like people are attracted to us or they're messaging us around something or even throwing their money at us, we can feel like, oh my gosh, this is working. Like, of course I should be doing this. Or if someone tells you that, oh my God, you're so talented or experienced or whatever in this area, we can be like, okay, like that's what they say, then I should keep going. I should keep doing this. Even if it's not feeling true or in alignment for us. So for example, inside of my business for a really long time, people were telling me that I was great at the business strategy. I was an amazing business coach and super helpful in terms of launching and with sales funnels and blah, 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 all these things. And I was like, okay, great. I like doing that. I really do. But there's something else that's missing. There's something else that I feel like I haven't touched or tapped into that I really want to. But I was being told that I was good at something. People were paying me a really solid amount to do something. And my coach at the time had told me that I needed to lead with the business side of things. And that, because at the time I wanted to weave more spiritual and woo-woo stuff in. But she said basically that I shouldn't and that people weren't going to pull out their credit cards for that. So I had all of these signs that like I should be doing something a certain way. And that was really hard. And I've shared this story many times before, but when I hit six figures inside of my business, instead of feeling really excited or free or whatever, I felt so depleted, so burnt out, so not excited about what I was doing. And I knew that I had to do something differently. I burnt out. I literally burned myself down. And I had to then burn my business down and, like a phoenix, have it rise from the ashes and do something different, take a different approach. So I'm curious to hear what you guys have to say. Like, if you think that you should, or if you feel pressured inside of your business to do something, if you feel pressured to do business in a certain way, or like you have to continue on because you are good at it, because someone's paying you for it. But I also want to talk about the steps you can take to burning it down and recreating it. So first, I want you to get really clear about what's not working right now inside of your business. So for even those of you who are watching this and are like, you know what, I love my business, things are going well, but like it could be even better. I want you to take some time, whether it's journaling after this or talking to a friend about this or a coach about this, and thinking about, one, what do I absolutely hate inside of my business? What drives me crazy? What stresses me out? What gives me anxiety? What do I wake up being like, oh, like I really, really don't want to do that? Or anything that you're doing at the time where it's like, it's boring, it's dull, whatever it is, anything that you hate doing. And I want you to write that down. And like, why do you hate it? Is it just because it's like monotonous? Or is it because it's actually really stressful? Like maybe for you, like group programs can be like really stressful, or the group program you just ran was really stressful. And like, why was it stressful? So getting detailed about what's not going so hot inside of your business. Two, I want you to start to think about what you would love to have inside of your business, what you truly desire, even if it feels outrageous, like a total long shot, even if you feel like, oh, like who am I to want this? Who am I to have this? I want you to write it down, because a lot of the times we are denying and suppressing our true desires, and that's keeping us stuck, that's keeping us spinning in these circles, and that's no good for anybody. So write down what you truly desire. Now I want you to think about moving forward. So step three here is, what can you do to either, one, get rid of that task or that part of your business that you completely hate? So completely burn that part to the ground. Is that possible? Or two, something that you can start to delegate to somebody else or hand off to like a team member or somebody else, so you are not the one who's doing it. So if you feel like it is an integral part of your business, you still want that thing, you just don't want to be the one doing it, think about how you can delegate it. So either one, like you don't need it, burn to the ground, get rid of it, it's holding you back, or two, find a way to delegate it, or three, find a way to make it more fun or more interesting if you can't delegate yet, or if you think it's something that you can reinvent relationship around it. So then with the things that you would love to do that you are truly desiring, I would love to hear like what these things are too. So type them in the comments if you're watching live. If you're watching the replay, pop them in the comments too so I can go back and help you like work through these things. But when it comes to what you're desiring, what can you start to implement now? What's one tiny step you can take to put that thing in place inside of your business? So for example, if you are like, oh my gosh, I would love to run retreats. Like that is exactly like what I want to be doing, but I'm super scared or nervous about it or whatever, but I know that's what I really want to do. Then like, what's one step you can take to get there? Well, maybe go and attend a retreat yourself. Like see what it's like. Get a feel for what you like on the retreat, what you don't like, how you can start to make this your own. If you've gone to a bunch of retreats before, think about things that you've liked, things that you didn't like, how you can start to create a really unique experience, and just start to even brainstorm what it would look like. Really entertain the idea and dive into it, because so often we have these ideas and we whoop, swipe them to the side. But I want you to dive into it and go even deeper. Then I would say, like, let's say your dream is to have a retreat and there's 20 women there and it's in like Hawaii and whatever. If you feel like that's too big of a step right now, which it's probably not, but if you feel like it's too big of a step, then like, let's go to the first step. So for example, could you, if you live in Boston like myself, could you host a small intensive or a mini retreat where it's 2 days, it's in Boston, in your city, so it's easy. You're inviting 5 people or even 3 people or whatever to come join you for those 2 days to hold the space for them and to dive into the content that you may do in your bigger retreat. So you at least get practice and you're starting to take the action of making that dream a reality. So I want you to start to think about what are those things that you can burn down inside of your business. What are those things that you really desire that you can invite into your business, and how you can ultimately create a business that is so completely aligned with you and your desires, so you're not copying someone else's business model. So you're not doing the things that everybody says you have to do and following the rules, but you're really creating success on your own terms. And inside of the episode two, we talked about how to do this inside of your life. So how to start creating and living the lifestyle that you desire right now, and how your business can help fuel that and support this lifestyle. So definitely go check out the episode, but I would love to hear in the comments how you plan on reinventing, improving, or even burning your business down completely. So if you are ready to just completely scrap it and start fresh, amazing. I know how scary that can be, and it doesn't sound very amazing right now. But there's something really incredible that happens when we get super honest with ourselves and what we really desire to do, rather than what we're supposed to do or what we think would get us money, create success, etc. So if you have any questions about this or how to reinvent yourself inside of your business, reach out, post in the comments, let me know. I also have a really incredible and special opportunity coming up for women who you've tried all the things, you've heard all the strategies, you've been inside of all the programs, and you know, you've gained things here or there, but you've just been inundated with information and you don't need any more information. You're really ready to create success on your own terms and create a business that fuels you, like really, truly fuels your soul and helps you create a lifestyle that you love. This is also something for people who are really looking to step up into their thought leadership, who are looking to share their message and their truth in a really big way and create a really engaged community of incredible people. And like I said, just really on your own terms. So if this sounds like something that you're interested in, if you feel like you've been stuck right now or you're confused about how to move forward, how to really step up into your thought leadership, how to really create this aligned business that feels so fucking good, then reach out to me, send me a message, because I am creating something right now really special for women like you. And this is not something that I'm gonna be making public for some time now. So this is just for my VIP peeps like you who are watching right now. So if this sounds like something that you would love to learn more about, then feel free to shoot me a message. And I would love to hop on a call with you or just chat it out and see how we can help you go from where you are right now to what you truly desire, because I promise you, everything you desire is truly possible, and I love supporting my clients in doing this. All right, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and be sure to go through the exercise that I just did with you guys. Pop it in the comments. And if you really are excited about creating success on your own terms and stepping up into your thought leadership, send me a message so I can share a little bit more about the details of this program. And of course, go and check out the 50 Shades of Truth episode that I just did with Amanda Bond, because it is bomb.com. Okie dokie. Bye, everybody.